You know, I'm not gonna. Excuse me. I'm not gonna blast my Facebook page with all advertising right now. I'm just gonna. Yeah, which one is which? Okay. I didn't know. Okay, so the purple one is like the modifiers and comp. What does that mean? Oh, that's kind of cool. Okay, well, here we go. Let's give this one a shot. I wonder what it is. It looks, I mean, there's an option to turn off the lights. I'm guessing it might be a scary game. Or turn on the lights. We'll see.
Hi, Mom. So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
June 7th, 1995, 1:15 a.m. Oh god, it is a point and click. Man. Okay, so there's me. I'm a girl named Caitlin. Flight number 270, June 6th, 1995. See what all this stuff is. Oh, there's a key. Hey, girl. Got it. Can I throw it? I can throw it. I can't be there to see you, but it is impossible. Please don't go digging around trying to find out where I am. I don't want anyone to know. We'll see each other again someday. Don't be worried. Love you, Sam. Huh. Alright. Okay. Directions to work from new house. Left on Grabtree. Can I just take this? No, can't. Hour and 10 minutes. Dang. So good to hear from you again. All this new house business sounds like quite the adventure. Remember the little dorm room we shared freshman year? When we when we were miserable, fantasizing about our dream homes. I've always said I wanted a mansion. You said you just wanted a house in the woods. Look who got both. Somebody up there likes you. I could use some of that magic. Send me some lotto numbers, I'll play them. Seriously. But I shouldn't be complaining about this good old split level we've had since Bob got transferred to Winnipeg. You just got new vinyl siding. Jealous yet? Let me know if you ever want to trade places. So how are the girls doing? Has Katie left on her big European adventure yet? Speaking of jealous, right back soon. I miss you, Rumi. Carol. Okay, so Carol is a person in the universe. Nonsense. Terrence Greenbrier. Okay.
Dear Katie.
What the fuck?
So much has changed, even just since you've been away. We moved into this house. I'm at a new school. And my big sister being gone for a year doesn't make it any easier. It doesn't feel real. But I'm not gonna let it faze me. I used to tell you everything, and if I can't do it in person, because you're off gallivanting around who knows where, I'll tell it to this journal, just like I was talking to you.
Supposed to do? Okay. So if I go here, this is a closet. Okay. That's my mom, I think. What the f- I have a doggone cool 17th birthday. Birthday Santa. Okay. Weird.
Sam? Hello? Sam!
Hold on. We're going to go ahead and read this first. Okay. Daniel from the old neighborhood called. He wants to come see the new house. Call him back. Mom, Daniel is a weirdo. The only reason why I ever hung out with him in the first place is he had a Nintendo when we were little. Messed up. Okay, yeah, so...
Sam.
What's going on?
be there.
What?
Hi, Mom. So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up.
Okay,
like,
so
really
Sam
seriously,
is that's Sam.
Okay, so love you.
There's
see
me.
You soon. Bye.
That's my mom and that's my dad. Seems kind of freaking me out already. I don't like all this silence. There's gonna be some jump scare bullshit. I'm gonna freak out. I'm not a fan of these type of games. Okay, let's do. Couples bowling. Bowling. Oh. Wait, never mind. Okay, so it's bowling, cooking, and then dancing. Temporary personal transfer. Bruce Pendleton, head of personnel, state charge for service. To aid the upcoming prescribed burn operation, Ranger with expertise in procedures being transferred to the station at Flintlock National Hospital, effective 9/2/94. Please see attached personnel file. The overseeing officer at Flint Hook. Okay. Oh, what's that? There's a cassette. Can I play it maybe in the answering machine? It's a Brett. Okay, so. Oh. What? Stop. I'm gonna read these. You love things, stab cherry bomb. Ah, cherry bomb's a good song. Fuck your fans. Polaroid baby. Panic. Bitch theme. Richard. Cool Schmoll. Ah, whatever. Excuse me.
It's weird hanging out with girls. Daniel was around ever since I was little, and other girls? I don't know. But being around Lonnie is like instantly just right. I gave her the grand Psycho House tour and took my revenge on Super Nintendo. And it was like, I don't know, I finally found someone I feel normal around. I drove her home and she gave me this tape and said, "You have got to listen to this." I haven't stopped playing it since.
What? Okay. Oh. Well, the tape's not in it. That's why I was like, okay. Sam, I think the creative writing. A drawer. Crisco! What's up, man? I am just thoroughly confused. AIDS in Africa, suicidal life. This is amazing. Hey, X-Files. Okay, so I need some type of code. I don't know what the code is. But have you beaten this game before or played it? What a board game. Why? Okay, so you have... Okay, I'm... Okay, boop, we can do that better. Oh,
we're
seriously?
So cool, yeah, we're so cool, We're so cool, Fuck you, too! Cool, smooth!
Oh, this is the... Okay, so... Okay, so you can... So if you know where to go and stuff, it's a fast playthrough. Wait, so I actually find, like, an answer? Right, no, not a whole lot's happening. Am I dead? Is that the... Okay, so the game is... Wait, so I find, like... Oh, lost my TV. Okay, so I just cruise around and look... I just look for different clues and stuff? Adventurous. Huh. That's kind of cool. Oh, I used to like these things. Hold on, I'm sure I can get this one. Okay, that one's a heart. It's a shark. Okay. Hey, some more games. Journey of Crystal. Okay, so I have to just... I mean, what do I have to do? Ugh. This is the me and dad are building. Okay, so they, so the sister and the dad are building a bike. You're 11. Excuse me. Well, C minus. What? Then apply for her enforcement. Oh, that's a. What was that from? That's from the portrait downstairs. Okay, so I can go this way. I haven't been here yet. Oof, what was that? Oh, it's hair dye in the water.
Lonnie brought her hair dye over today. She said, I need to fix these roots. Think you could help? Dyeing hair is weirdly intimate. I don't know if I've touched someone else's scalp before. That's pretty intimate, right?
Quite a bit of creep.
It felt intimate. We looked in the mirror together after, and I expected her to say something about how it looked crappy, or good, or whatever. But that's when she said, you're so beautiful. And she was looking at me. Right in that moment, I wanted to say something, but I waited, and the moment was gone.
Toilet paper. Shane, you want to go see Pulp Fiction after school at the Coliseum? It came out last weekend and Todd won't shut up about it. So either it's good or we can make fun of him for liking it. My mom was supposed to cook dinner for us tonight for a change, but I can just ditch out on it probably. What time also? Isn't that movie supposed to be really violent? Am I going to barf? According to Todd, it's pretty hardcore. I guess Uma Thurman gets stabbed in the heart with a heroin needle. So that's kind of hilarious. Also, something about cheeseburgers is important. Todd wants to see it again. 7:15, okay? Don't barf. Get out of here. Can't see stuff. I'm stupid. I just realized that. I mean, I noticed there were different handwriting, but they're passing that back and forth. Ugh, I'm stupid. Anyway, moving on. Okay, so nothing in the bathroom. Toothpaste. Tooth stuff. Oh, is this their book? I don't know. In the bathtub. Nothing down there. In the bathtub. Can I go to towels? No. That's a nonsense. There's nothing in these drawers. All the President's Men, Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. Gone with the Wind. Sound of Music. Inside Edition. Huh? Bridge on the River Kwai. Sounds of the Lambs. Control burn scan of a boot in the case of this burn. We talked about that earlier. Okay. Okay, so this was that plaque that they were talking about with the... See, like a C on it or something. You see what... Yeah, she messed it up. Welcome, new student. I hope you are excited for the first day at Goodfellow High School as we are. Okay.
Oh my god. You are so lucky you finished high school before we moved into this house. So, it's the first day of school, and there I am, introducing myself to the class. And I say that I just moved into the house on Arbor Hill. All of a sudden, every kid in the room turns and just stares like I suddenly transformed into a mutant. I just stood there, pushing pretty hard for a rewind button. Because now maybe nobody knows my name, but they all know who I am. The Psycho House Girl. Great.
Take his... Okay. Mom and Dad, I'm in Paris. I've done so many Parisian things. Blah, 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 blah. So... So I think I gotta get. Oh, okay, so I need some combinations. Let's open his eyes and saw them stars twinkling as they're lying on the. Okay, so you spelled process wrong. that? Stupid Facebook. Get out of here. I'm not gonna lie, that actually kind of scared me. Okay, so they bought a laser disc player? What if JFK wasn't JFK? This is okay. Wiring in-house technically up to safety and amperage requirements. However, multiple layers of wiring have been added into the structure over the past 100 years. System is frequently unpredictable. Lights blink out for no clear reason. Pressure on floorboards and doorframe disrupts circuits wired directly. Behind the surface... Probably working electrical system would be highly destructive to the walls, floor, and fixture of the structure. After discussing with Mr. Greenbrier, since there are no current safety concerns, issues will not be addressed. Okay. So there's, so far we know there's a there was a controlled burn in the area. And that the house has suspect suspect wiring in the house. But the house is fine, so danger under my roof. Teen years or fraud change. Okay. On the floor. Okay, I can still go over here. That kind of freaked me out that the TV was on.
Secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
Okay. Piece of cake to make friends.
Following counties. Austin County.
That's sad.
County.
What? County. Okay, so she's like kind of depressed. Possibly gay.
You know that feeling where the first moment you see someone, it's like they have a big gold star around them, and you have to get to know them. Well, there's this girl. I think she's a senior. She's usually dressed kind of punk. But sometimes I see her in this, like, army uniform. She's always drawing in this notebook, looking so intense. I had no idea how I would ever, like, have an excuse to talk to her. Till I noticed she and her friends hang out and play Street Fighter at the 7-Eleven every day after school.
Batmobile.
Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
X-Files Season 1, hey! They have a lot of cables. Like a lot of... This is, You know what?
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties.
Yeah, it looks kind of like the Super Nintendo.
Boone County, Dawn County, Tecumseh County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions
are
expected at lower elevations.
Okay, so they saw Pulp Fiction. Hell yeah, X-Files. Get it.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties. Austin County, Boone County, Dawn County, Tecumseh County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged to
There's something. Okay. Terry, hey man, how you been? I know you're a public author and everything, but my editor at Hi-Fi Aficionado has too much review work to go around and he's looking for another freelancer. Naturally, I thought of you. You were saying in your last letter how much of a pain it has been trying to find a publisher for your latest work in literature, and writing stereo reviews is dead simple. Sit at home with a glass of scotch, listen to some records, and write up how it sounds, and then get paid. I've included some issues of the mag to use as examples. If you're interested, send some samples to my editor and tell him your old college... No? Chum. Oh, it says chum. Those colors. Who says chum? Mike sent you. Here's the address. Okay.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties: Austin County, Boone County, Dawn County, Tecumseh County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors.
Tape in this.
And secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions.
Matches in there? No, they're not. Like, they're all empty. Turn it around. ready. Hadouken.
So you know what they say about the best laid plans of mice and men? Yeah, turns out it applies to Street Fighter 2. At least I worked up the courage to walk into the 7-Eleven and ask for a turn, but all that practice at home did not exactly translate in the wild. So after I was finished getting my butt kicked, I followed them outside while they smoked. And that was when she asked me if I was that psycho house girl. But then she said she's always really wanted to see the psycho house. Her name is Lonnie. She's coming over tomorrow.
I guess I need a key. Please tell Mom and Dad sorry about the stuff that's missing. What the fuck? Wait, what just happened? What? So I can't go. So where can I go now? Oh, do I have to find a key? That's his review of that thing. Okay, I read that one already. Over here.
Sam. Sam. Hello. Sam.
Look, who's just calling? So now I'm stuck. Oh, it's a board game. Of course it's locked. Where is the key? Thank you. Only I could turn a game like this into unbeatable. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Yeah. Where would you put a key? Or maybe it's in these things. Hecho en México. Nothing in any of these. Under the rug? I don't know. Can't open that. It's looking like I need two. Two combinations. And two keys. Alright, see you later, Trey. I'm still completely lost. I don't know what I'm doing. So the cassette thing, I did. Like, it triggered a journal entry, so I don't need that anymore. Oh, here's some stuff. Samantha Greenbrier, 17 years old, and therefore an independent, fully functioning human being. The fact that you guys so forbid me from going into the city on my own is frankly absurd. Compare with Katie, who's only 3 years older than me, and yet you allowed her to go all the way across an ocean to another continent on her own. I just want to spend an evening in a normal, totally safe city on my own, like a human being, in a sense. And she may also remember that I have my own car now. You can't really stop me. Warmest regards, your daughter Samantha. Daniel calling. He wants his Nintendo game back. Oh, hello. What are you doing? Oh, I don't think I was in this room yet. Mom and Dad were going to make up the guest room for you to stay in all the summer, but you came home on such short notice. They weren't around to do it. You can use my room if you want. I won't be needing it anymore. Oh, so she left. She's all mad and she left. Hey, there's something. Okay, what's this? You're asking what my JROTC ribbons meant. Here's a handy guide. Okay, so Lonnie is like her maybe girlfriend. Maybe. Okay. Tall shadow in the upstairs hall. When I ran to the corner, no one was there. How tall was Uncle Oscar? Notice. No, I was not wearing my glasses. Oh, so she's seeing ghosts now. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. A faint voice coming from the bottom of the stairs said, hello. Did not investigate. Probably was the furnace. Poured milk from carton in fridge. It was spoiled. Pretty sure I read that spirits can sour milk. Milk was just bought yesterday. Moo. Almost ghost milk. Lonnie says she feels a presence in the TV room. I suddenly begin to feel cold. We build a protective pillow. Okay, so that's why that's there. Lonnie and I employ a Ouija board as a medium. Disturbing messages are conveyed from the other side. Oscar is definitely here. Oscar? Oh, that's that guy that died. Enlisted Lonnie to stay up all night and help patrol premises, recording any signs of otherworldly presence. Lonnie reported many sightings, but all remained unconfirmed. Possible ectoplasm in the attic. Probably due to a leaky roof. Sample taken just in case. Despite our best efforts, we both fell asleep around 4 a.m. All in all, a successful night. Uh-oh. Okay, so she like moved out. Oh, is that another... What the fuck? Okay, that's the attic. Performance evaluation. Richard Pattermach. Supervisor, Janice Greenbrier. I believe his expertise and dedication have been deciding factors in the success of a very complex, challenging conservation effort. In the opinion of the Flintlock Forest staff, his contributions to daily operations have become essential to the office continuing to success. To this end, I will be formally submitting paperwork requesting his permanent reassignment to this facility. Okay, so somebody helped out with that burn. He did a very good job. which are the Misfits. Don't forget your costume. Digging Lounge, 10:29 p.m. Okay, so...
Sometimes you just have to lie to Mom and Dad. Like when Lonnie asked me to see a band with her and stay over at her friend's place in the city after. That's a lie to Mom and Dad's situation. But it was so worth it. The girls on stage were just so loud and real and awesome. And everybody was moving together like one huge tide of sound. Between two songs, Lonnie leaned over and said, "How do you like your first show?" I was so happy. I felt tears starting in my eyes. And then she up and hugged me. I think she could tell.
Let's see what this tape has to offer. Hey man, this is a game called Gone Home. Not really sure what to make of it, to be honest with you. I'm a girl who comes home from a trip to Europe, and the house is empty. And from what I've been told, you need to figure out why it's empty and where everybody is. And calculated. Okay, so now there's a secret. Okay, so there's a secret path that goes from the library to the closet in the master room. Whoa, okay. Okay, yeah, so that's it now. Huh. This is crazy. This thing. It's open, but it's weird. Don't look here. What? Maybe there's another thing that has a cassette tape. So I can't go to the attic yet. Oh, there's another. There's a bunch of them. What the hell? Okay. This is starting to get weird. Because right now I'm in... Okay, so I've been here before. Misfits. Oh, it's the Misfits. I get it.
At Todd's brother's place after the show, there was only a futon to sleep on, so Lonnie and I shared
451.
The lights went out. I was turned toward her. My eyes started to adjust, and then I could see she was looking at me, too. In the dark, she smiled. My heart was beating so fast. I rolled over. I felt so, I don't know, nervous? After a minute, she put her arm around me and was so close and whispered in my ear, "I really like you." I just nodded my head and I really hope she could tell. I really hope that she meant what I think she did. I felt like a shook-up can of soda ever since. I hope we have the chance to talk before I explode.
So 0451 is one of the... to be here. Hey! So what's in here? Let's go. I, Oscar Mason, possessing full competence in mind and memory. After full survey of valued items to my name, do hereby declare this document be my last will and testament. The following shall be true upon my passing. I declare that I am a lifelong resident of Boone County, that I am unmarried and have no children. I declare I have no outstanding debts to my name, to any creditors living or dead. I do hereby bequeath every item of value of which I may die possessed, including the dwelling... Wait, what? I do hereby bequeath every item of value of which I may die possessed, including the dwelling and surrounding acres located at Arbor Hill, as well as any all personal property and money to count, to my nephew, Terrence Greenbar Jr. of Ellis County. In the event that said Terrence Greenbrier Jr. should predecease me, then and in such event, the bequest to him shall fall at the same as bequeathed to his children, as ordered by age and competence, as stewards of the estate. I subscribe my name to this will, 13th day of August 1973. Oh, that's the... okay. So that's that, just typed out. That is. That. Okay, so there might be another panel or something over here. There we go. Okay. What? Oh! Okay. There's that. Okay, have anything to where perhaps did not read. Allegra and her scouting party peered down warily through the dense canopy of rustling leaves from their perch high in the forest branches. Mere feet away, sunlight shone brightly off the inner ice walls of the glacial basin in which the forest grew. It was a strange sight indeed, such lusciousness juxtaposed with the frigid icy formations. Allegra leapt forward without hesitation, bounding through the high branches. The first mate had been captured by the Green Glacier's Amazonian tribe. His life hung in the balance. "We have to hurry." Allegra's party followed behind, moving quietly as a breeze through the greenery. Allegra landed in a clearing and shouted, "Stop!" She saw the Queen Amazonian up on her pedestal, reaching for the lever that would drop her first mate into the vat below. She shouted, "No!" and flung her saber at the Amazon's reaching hand, but it was too late. The first mate screamed as he fell toward the water and then splashed down, and all was eerily silent. Allegra looked on, frozen in fear and remorse. She had been a moment too late. But then from the vat, something began to emerge. A head of dark brown hair, just like the first mate's. Then the shoulders and sleeves of his coat, soaking wet. But as the figure stood and the water poured down, Allegra saw that the first mate had changed. He was no longer a man at all. In fact, what looked back at her were the eyes, face, and hair and hands, body of a woman, still in the first mate's clothes. Still the first mate, she spoke in a soft, clear voice. "Captain?" The Amazonian queen said, "She is one of us now. She is ours." Damn! That's crazy. Allegra drew her magical flintlock pistols from her belt, and the crew readied their swords. Allegra glared into the queen's eyes and said, "That's the love of my life, but you can't have her." Okay. Okay, so I have half of it. So what's the other half? Where's the other thing? Here's the other half of the locker. Right on, right on. There's the Ouija boards. What do you want to come? Oof. It's kind of creepy, no? Okay, well, I have that, so I'm going to do this now. O, 15, and 1. What is this? Gentleman Magazine. Great beautiful cover up. Morley Cigarettes is the brand that is in the X-Files. That's what the cigarette smoking man smokes, Morley's. It's pretty cool.
Lonnie came over today, but everything was different. She was sitting at my desk chair, and she wouldn't look at me. Finally, I asked her what was going on. She said she felt like she'd done something wrong that night in the city. Like I must think... But I said no, there was nothing wrong. I just wanted to say... But I couldn't find the words. I felt like I was gonna cry, but I wasn't sad. She got up and sat next to me on the bed. I looked at her. Lonnie, do you think you could ever... And that's when she kissed me.
Adventurous, the cat returns. Okay, so she has a little girlfriend now.
You're so cool, yeah.
Oh. So now I gotta go to the basement. I'd like to cordially thank you for having me over to your abode for the Thanksgiving holiday with your lovely family. I enjoyed the flavorful potatoes, and also it was weird being around your parents for that long, but it was pretty funny how impossible it is for your dad not to be awkward for more than 30 seconds at a time. Mr. Soto. Oh, that's her, okay. Thank you again for being such a gracious host of the festivities at your father's estate, following the aforementioned meal with my parents. Family Thanksgiving feast was the more enjoyable of the two events, I must say. I especially appreciated the time I spent with your grandmother, who was a lovely woman with sterling taste and a refined air. Let's do it again sometime next year, shall we? Indeed, Madame Samantha Greenbrier, Esquire. Okay, so they hung out at each other's houses for Thanksgiving. Now she's starting to...
It's different now. I mean, we still hang out all the time like before. But now when no one else is around... Well, you know. So you could say we're dating. But it's secret. Secret dating? I don't know. I mean, I guess that's the real difference. Now when we get off the phone or go home for the night. Or it's just quiet and we're alone. We say I love you.
Gillian Breyer, I guess. Oh, this was... redo. Reed College. Samantha, okay. Congratulations. Please inform you your admission to Creative Writing Track and Reed College Summer Program for Young Scholars. Okay, so she got into college.
Okay. I'm so stupid sometimes. I was telling Lonnie that I got into my college summer program thing, and I was all making plans like, you should come visit me, stay in my dorm room. But she said, Sam, I ship out on June 6th. I was like, ship out? To where? She said, to basic training. What did you think I was doing all that ROTC stuff for? I guess she's been planning to join the army right after high school since she was like 12. And I guess she's really going to do it. So I was like, after graduation, I'm just never going to see you again? She said, let's just have fun while we can.
That's sad. James Joyce. That's his book. Dear Chairs, thank you for sending along a copy of your newly published book. An author's first published manuscript is a momentous occasion. I read it this afternoon. I certainly recognize my son in the subject matter. An author's work is the externalization of that which he holds dear and that which he fears. And in this respect, I believe your work was successful. But the lens through which the personal shown was needlessly clouded by genre cliches and implausible dime store science fictional deus ex machinas. The great authors speak of their life's milieu in clear and honest tones, and the lens crystal that reflects their thoughts without distortion. I congratulate you on surviving the great ordeal that is publication, and rest assured that readers of your chosen genre will lap up copies hungrily, but I urge you to shed artifice. You can do better. With the father's love and encouragement, Richard Greenbrier, Dad. Okay. So the dad didn't like the book. What is this? Okay. Another combination. Assuming it's gonna be locked. Oh, I guess not. The key doesn't work. Oh wait, this is where I'm at right now. I'm in the corner. Yolanda DeSoto, Hair Factory Maria DeSoto, blah blah blah. Okay. Here's Sam. So these bands are X Fly, Moshe, Hair Factory, Samine, Azole, two or more. Okay. So happy you liked the drawing. I was thinking of us when I drew it, I knew you'd be able to tell. You love Mexico. I think probably. The nature here is totally different than back home, and I keep thinking about Allegra and the first mate lost on a mysterious island where even the plants are out to get them. I hear bed. And then I think of them together out there in the wilderness, too, and I start thinking of you again. I lie here in bed, and I've I can almost feel you. I've been trying to save it up for when we're together again. I haven't done a good job, okay? But I tried. Okay, enough about that. Your last letter got to me the day before we started driving back north. We'll be racing this letter home. If I get home first, we can read it together. Yes? I'm taking tons of photos and we'll spend so much time in the dark room. Lonnie. Second drug. First time was in my room in the middle of the night. I woke up and Lonnie was... What? Are you serious? What the hell just happened? Wait, what was that about? What was that? That was weird. Informant was a Cub Scout, Settlers, role model, authority, main speed, sensors.
Todd's band lost their singer. Todd said he sucked. Lonnie said he got sick of Todd's shit. And he was complaining about needing a new singer. So Lonnie was like, I can sing. And they were all kind of like, you can? And she was like, probably. But she's been rehearsing with them for like a week now. And I finally got to see them play in Todd's basement today. She's actually really amazing. I feel so proud when she's on stage. It's incredible being in awe of someone you love. So everybody knows it's like a temporary situation till she ships out in June. But till then, I'm gonna be at every single show.
Maybe just a... Oh, no, I thought it might be a combination or something on here, but no. Thank you. You've got to be fucking kidding me. Am I stuck? What's going on? I think I'm stuck. How and why am I stuck? Come on, man, really? I'm going to try to save and then quit to the menu. Resume. Hopefully I'm not stuck. If I'm stuck, I gotta do all this stuff again. I'm gonna be bummed out. Okay, there we go. I don't know what that was about. I got stuck. That was weird. See, I'm writing to you from Multnomah Falls. I don't know what that is. I'm here in a stupid class trip, which is stupid because it's March, and I don't know if anyone running the school has been to Oregon. But it's cold, rainy as shit in March. I wish you were here. Oh, wait, you are here because I'm writing this to you in the gift shop. Oh, shit, here you come.
They tell you to stick with the group on field trips, Katie. There's a reason for that. Lonnie and I snuck off on the side paths at Multnomah Falls and got a little lost. Okay, a lot lost. Like, for hours. Right before the bus left, we found a trail and came running down the path, soaked and covered in mud, shouting for the bus not to leave. The school called home. Mom and Dad said, "You didn't get into trouble like this before you met that Lonnie girl." But I don't think they know about us. The kids at school, though, I'm really afraid that's a whole other story. Stick with the group, Katie. Stick with the group.
Oh, this is a whole new area. Tougher than a wild Mustang. Girl Justice Fell. Sonic Youth, huh? Bikini guy. Oh, there's a tape somewhere. That's a light of mom and dad situation, but it's so worth it. The girls on stage were just so loud and real and awesome. Everyone was moving together like when he's tired of sound. It's like cool stuff about being a psycho house girl. Cool thing, everyone. Everyone in the hall. You don't know they're looking at you and whispering as you walk past because I guess they haven't heard peripheral costumes. Skeletons and devils, cheerleaders from the Smells Like Teen Spirit video, one girl dressed as Jackie Kennedy. I gotta find the tape. There it is. It's underwear. Oh! That's okay, that's where I am. There we go, okay. I'm starting to open up the house a little bit. Due to your exemplary management of the flint hook, after position. Sorry, my mom was such a bitch last night. She's hardly ever around since her forest is like an hour away, and then when she's home, she takes it out on you, like, because you're not a member of the family. She knows you won't call her on it, and I'm sorry. It's okay. I know she's just jealous of our cool and free-willing lifestyles. I feel sorry for you. I'm lucky my mom lives in Florida. You have to have a mom every day. So I didn't mean to bring it up in the monthly. I know I shouldn't complain. No, I'm being serious. My mom is a psycho Christian, and her new husband, Don, is a complete tool. Living in Florida with him is her eternal punishment in my mind. So you wouldn't rather live with your mom in Florida? Oof. No.
Katie, you know how Mom and Dad are. Not exactly super open-minded about things. It feels like every minute I don't spend with Lonnie, I spend worrying about them finding out about us. And what would happen if they did? You know Dad's joke about the nunnery that he'd tell whenever you brought boys around the old house? I wonder where he'd want to send me.
Earth, Wind, and Fire. This house is fucking big. Gold is closing in front of Mexico, and it was like $3. I love it. Merry Christmas. Okay. And I got two tickets for this one and Fire Thursday, but my girlfriend says she doesn't want to go. The Taste of Music rears its ugly head again. So that leaves me with an extra ticket I thought you might be interested in. More than playing Brush in the Freezing Rain, right? Or... Okay, so the mom got a date or something with some dude. No buts in heaven. Vatican is weird. As you can see, the Catholic Church has had a lot of money left over from the Middle Ages. I've gotten to see all the art, including the Sistine Chapel ceiling and the sculptures by Michelangelo, Donatello, and the rest of Ninja Turtles. Mom, we'll have to come back together. I would love to be here with someone who really appreciates the history behind everything. Also, Sam, they have various relics and the pieces of important dead people, so you should probably come too. Next up, Barcelona. Calm down, Dad. I won't get gored by a bull, probably. Sam, since you refuse to hear us out this afternoon, your mother and I are putting this in writing so we are absolutely clear. You are grounded for the rest of the month from social and telephone privileges and from using your car for anything except going to and from school. We understand what you are going through, but we can't allow you to continue with this kind of behavior at school. And clearly, once your privileges are reinstated, we can't allow you to have your bedroom door locked while Lonnie is at the house. This is the last word we're going to get back on course, so this won't have to happen again. Oh, she got detention.
I had an interesting talk with Mom and Dad tonight. One you were never gonna need to have. I mean, you've known, right? I've known. I've known since, like, She-Ra. Mom and Dad didn't, I guess. They saw the zine and the stuff on the locker, and they were like, is there something we should know about you and Lonnie? And so here's the thing.
Oh, damn.
I was prepared for them to be mad or disappointed or start crying or something, but they were just in denial. You're too young to know what you want. You and Lonnie are just good friends. You just haven't met the right boy. It's a phase.
Damn.
That's what I didn't see coming. That they wouldn't even respect me enough to believe me. Well, joke's on them, because they're in for one very long phase.
Wow. Okay. First off, congratulations, Janice, Regional Director, and congratulations because discuss the little outing you had with your favorite flannel-clad hunk. You sound like you're reading a lot in Innocent Night Out. You sure think there's something there? You said he has an out-of-town girlfriend. You sure they're not serious? Okay, so we have to figure out when we'll see each other next in person. Enough with the letters. Are you congratulatory, Margarita? Boss lady soon. Carol. Oh, the new job. How do I get in this room? Oh, it's his third book. Oh, okay, so I was here. Dining room. Burger on Bethel Road, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, 3 to 7, Saturday. Oh, I'm in the kitchen. Mr. and Mrs. Jonathan Blair request your honorary presence at the marriage of their daughter, Helen Margaret, to Richard Morris Hedermach. It's a terrible name. Sunday, the 4th of June, 1995, 4:30 in the afternoon. Okay. It's in the fridge. I don't think I'm doing anything productive right now. So I can close the dishwasher. Nothing in the drawers. Oh, all the food's in there. Some more pizza. Samantha and Daniel were in the woods one day. It was sunny, and they were on a adventure. But they went to the part of the woods, and it got dark. Daniel said, "Are you scared?" So Samantha said, "No." "Are you?" They laughed and went more into the bad part. Sorry, I can usually read. This is weird. Then they went to a part that was never there before. And there was a ship, a pirate ship, on an ocean. Samantha said, "I'll be the captain and you be the first mate." Daniel said, "Aye, aye, Captain," and they went on the pirate ship.
Daniel finally came over to get his game.
Oh, this is that kid.
I've been dreading it.
Yeah.
But he brought this story with him that I wrote when we were little. I started reading it. And then there I was, crying at the kitchen table.
I can't usually read. That was just terrible spelling.
He asked what was wrong, and I was thinking about how we used to be friends. How much I take him for granted. But instead, I told him about school and Dad and Lonnie. And then how sorry I was that I wasn't his friend anymore. He gave me a hug and said it was going to be okay. And for some reason, I almost believed him.
Oh, there's another tape somewhere. Let's go. Right, there you are. Hello. Oh, so this is his first book. Oh, it got made. Oh, I'm in a shed. This stuff is supposed to be in a shed. Okay. First, let me say I hope this missive finds you well. Hell, it feels like a goddamn miracle to find you at all. Do you know how long we've been trying to track you down? Worry not. We aren't the feds, the men in black, or any other sort of creeping, fascistic hobgoblins. In fact, we're on your side. Let me start from the beginning. Oh, so it's like, ooh, this is Illuminati stuff. Unknown Dimension is what you might call a specialist publishing house. We traffic in the weird. The ahead of his time, the lost but not forgotten by a small but dedicated group of plugged-in bibliophiles type of out there, mass market shunning visionary expression that refuses to be taken in on anything but its own terms. Blah, blah, blah. But ever since we discovered tattered copies of your accidental series at a church rummage sale in Long Branch, New Jersey, we've been trying to track down the author of this weird and dark American outsider art. It's just a kind of forgotten portal into 20th century civilization anxieties and delusions that our readers lose their minds over. James Bond and Harrison Ford might be the dick-swinging heroes of the modern suburban America wants. But John Russell, mild-mannered insurance agent by day, reckless history, revising sociopath by night, is a twisted peacekeeper that it deserves. It is our mission to bring him back to life. Okay, so I've typed plenty. What do we want from you? We want your permission to reprint the work, since your original publisher, Mercury Books, folded a decade ago. We want you to supply a new foreword for the books to appear in brand new editions of The Accidental Savior and The Accidental Pariah, to be produced by Unknown Dimensions as a limited run and marketed directly to our highly discerning customer base. As we want to offer you a portion of the proceeds, contract to follow, assuming you're interested in coming along with us for the Weird Odyssey. We look forward to embarking with you and thrusting your work screaming back into the sweaty palms of unsuspecting American public. It's about time. Blast off. Okay, so there's like some more interest in his book now. That's probably that girl's book, or that girl's hat. Okay.
I asked Lonnie what she had to do to get ready to ship out for basic training. She said, not a lot, really. You're not allowed to bring anything with you. You have no possessions. No contact with the outside world while you're in basic. You just train hard every day, and then you deploy from there. So, they'll just send her away. To who knows where. The other side of the country. The other side of the world. My mind, like, can't process it. She's really going to be gone. Just gone.
Lonnie, my parents are leaving town, so we'll have the run of the whole house till you leave. I imagine actually spending the night in my room instead of sneaking up to your usual spot in the attic. Or to our usual spot. Not that the attic doesn't have as musty allure, but my bedroom is warmer. Sam, we should defile your parents' bed while they're gone. That'll show them. Lonnie, you are gross, never change. Ask me about clown compost. Oh, put the lid on the trash can, okay. Well, I'm in the garage. This is a big place. Oh, I ordered the pizza. That's why there's no money. Okay. Makes sense. Why am I in here? nothing in there. Here's the hood. Microwave still. That's the pizza. So I've done all this. The toilet, because that's what you do. That's the laundry room. Laundry? Sam, I wish you knew how to explain it better. The Army is this thing I grew up with, and it's part of me. My dad's Army friends are like family. I've always known it was where I'd end up. I never thought of it any other way. I wish things could be different. Maybe someday when I'm settled at a base and you're done with college, and you're a famous writer, and I can rebuild the tank engine with my eyes closed. Things will be different, and we can be together. Until then, they're breaking up. Oh, hey. Oh, that's where they went. They went to a... Oh, damn. This is not a vacation. They went to a... couples counseling. Because the girl went on a date or something. Damn, scandalous. Can't tell you what a joy it is to see John Russell back in print. Thank you very much for sending along copies of the new editions. The cover art is really something. I know you've said that Unknown Dimensions isn't in the business of printing new material, but this... revised interest in my work has brought on a wave of inspiration, resulting in manuscripts that completes John Russell's journey, which I think you may find intriguing. It is reflective and introspective without forgetting the excitement and weirdness that Unknown Dimension readers expect. Hope this might be an exciting new direction for Unknown Dimensions to pursue. At the very least, I'm grateful that John Russell's adventure didn't come to an end quite when I thought they had. Okay, so... he was writing the third book. It was 20 years since John Russell heard the call. Twice he saved the president's life. He's practically forgotten the days of the future of danger and excitement. The days where he mattered. It's late. So when the familiar ripping time opens in front of him and his handlers peer out, he doesn't hesitate. Is the president in danger? No, the life you save this time will be your own. Dun dun dun. Put the pen up there. Because why not? Okay. Oh, there's another.
We agreed our last night together would be our happiest ever. And we'd forget tomorrow was going to come at all. It worked for a while. We had a good time seeing Oscar off, then ran up to the attic to look through our photos, to find one for Lonnie to take with her. and looking at them, I realized they were all in the past. And there wouldn't be any more. And I didn't know what I was going to do. And I cried. And she held me. She said she knew it was hard, but life would move on. I said I didn't want my life to keep moving without her. That's when she cried too. I was so exhausted. I must have fallen asleep like that, in her arms. In the morning, I woke up, and I was finally alone.
Wait, there's something here. What? Oh, is this that little... Oh, this is that little spot. What the fuck? Okay, add a key.
The sunset light in this house is the saddest thing I've ever seen. I just want to sleep. When I'm in the attic, it almost feels like Lonnie could still be here. She's just downstairs. I'm just waiting to hear her pull down the hatch and come running up. Maybe I'll go up to the attic. And wait.
Oh no. Is what I think gonna happen gonna happen? Photo development stuff.
Katie, I'm so sorry that I can't be there to see you in person, that I can't tell you all this myself. But I hope as you read this journal and you think back, that you'll understand why I had to do what I did.
What?
And that you won't be sad, and you won't hate me, and you'll just know that I am where I need to be. I love you so much, Katie. I'll see you again. Someday. Love, Sam.
Oh man, that is brutal. I'm guessing she killed herself. She went up to the attic and killed herself. That's what I'm guessing.